36th inaugural lecture series of the University of Benin, to be delivered by Professor Adedapo Babatunde Ande. Topic: Blessed Amidst Women, the Odyssey of an Obstetrician Gynecologist. May I humbly invite the registrar OA Oshodi, Mrs. Ebley, represented by the deputy registrar, Mr. Adedo, to introduce the vice chancellor and members of the vice chancellor's procession. The registrar.
Distinguished guests and invitees, ladies and gentlemen, you are welcome to the 176th of the inaugural lecture series of the University of Benin. Please permit me to dwell on the existing protocol already observed by the University PRO. It is my singular honor and privilege to introduce the Vice Chancellor's entourage, which is led by the Vice Chancellor Professor FFO Orumase, who is ably represented by the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic Professor Abiodun Falodun. We also have His Royal Highness Professor SEO Adua Ujegban, Deputy Vice Chancellor at Ekawan Campus. The University Librarian is represented by Mr. Luke O. Obasui. The University Bursa is represented by Pastor G. Ewarau. The other side of the desk, we have Provost, Deans and Directors, the Provost, College of Medical Sciences, Professor V.I. Iyawe. Representing the Dean School of Postgraduate Studies, we have representing the Dean of Postgraduate Studies, we have Dr. D. Izeko. Dean of Students, Professor O.B. Osadolo. Dean, Faculty of Management Sciences, Professor I.O. Osamoyi. Dean, Faculty of Arts, Professor L. Otoide. Dean, School of Basic Medical Sciences, Professor Mrs. H. A. Obo. Acting Dean, School of Dentistry, Professor O. N. Obwekwe. Sorry, Professor Obwekwe is a full dean, it's Dean, School of Dentistry. Acting Dean, Faculty of Education, Acting Dean, School of Faculty of Education, Professor E.O.S. Iyamu. Dean of Engineering, Professor F.A. Isien. Dean, Faculty of Law, Professor N.A. Inegbedion. Representing the Dean, Faculty of Life Sciences, we have Professor S.E. Omodigo. Host Dean, School of Medicine, Professor M.I. Momo. Dean, Faculty of Pharmacy, Professor J.O. Akere. Representing Dean, Faculty of Physical Sciences, we have Professor E. Ahemelo. Directors here present, Director Institute of Child Health, Representative Dr. D.U. Uwaneri. Director General Studies, Professor J.A. Akbobi. Director Center for Patent Studies, Professor Mrs. K.A. Elafon. Director ICTU CRPU, Professor F.O. Ekaise. Acting Director IPAES, Dr. S.O. Aibiyi. And the last not the least, Acting Director Institute of Education, Dr. D. Omorupe. May I respectfully invite the Vice Chancellor to introduce the inaugural lecturer, the Vice Chancellor.
Of the University of Benin, members of Senate, Provost, College of Medical Sciences, Deans of Faculties and Schools, Directors of Institutes, staff and students of our great University of Benin, gentlemen of the press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, greetest Univen, I bring you warm felicitations from our highly revered Vice Chancellor, Professor FFO Orobrensi, who is unavoidably absent due to very pressing national assignment. The Vice Chancellor sends his greetings. I also bring you the Vice Chancellor's condolence message to the Department of O&G, the School of Medicine, the College of Medical Sciences, and to the entire University of Benin community of the sudden demise of our highly distinguished professor, a scholar, a brother, a colleague, a friend, Professor J.U. Onaitawa. Our Vice Chancellor, Professor FFO Orobrensi, was deeply pained by the news of the sudden death of our lecturer, Professor Onaitawa. Very distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I now most humbly and respectfully present the Vice Chancellor's address. I warmly welcome you all to the 176th in the inaugural lecture series of the University of Benin. Today's lecture is the 29th to be delivered in my tenure as the Vice Chancellor of this great university. The 36th lecture to be delivered in the College of Medical Sciences, and the 27th in the School of Medicine, University of Benin. As part of my routine update on activities of the university, I'm pleased to inform you that the just concluded regional DLG, DFG, and Alexander von Humboldt capacity building workshop was a huge success. The essence of the capacity building workshop was to expose researchers, lecturers, and scholars of the university to scholarship, fellowship, and grant opportunities available in Germany. The dividend have started unfolding as some staff and students are already working positively towards attaining the world-class scholarship from Germany. I want to use this opportunity to thank the organizing committee for a job well done. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my pleasure to now introduce our lecturer for the day, Professor Adedako Babatunde Ande, whose lecture will be on Blessed Amidst Women, the Odyssey of an Obstetrician Gynecologist. Professor Ande was born on 15th March 1961 at Kano City to the family of Deacon Simeon Adebola Ande and Mrs. Motupola Ande of Ogbomoso North Local Government Area, Oyo State. He had his primary school education in several primary schools in the northern Nigeria due to family commitments before completing his primary education at Methodist Primary School, Yaba, Lagos. He moved to Baptist Grammar School, Ibadan, for his higher school education from 1973 to 1977, and obtained his A-level certificate from the School of Basic Studies, Ilorin, from 1978 to 1979. He proceeded to the University of Ibadan in 1979 for a BSc degree in biochemistry. He served a one-year mandatory National Youth Service between 1982 and 1983 as science teacher at Government Secondary Technical School and as a laboratory staff at General Hospital, URH Sokoto State. From 1984 to 1989, he was at Obafemi Awolowo College of Health Sciences, Ogun State University, now Olabisi Onabanjo University. For the Master, for the Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Surgery degree. His housemanship was rotated around the State Hospital of Ademola Maternity and the General Hospital in Abeokuta from 1989 to 1990. His postgraduate residency training was at the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology, University of Benin Teaching Hospital from 1991 to 1996. Professor Ande joined the services of the University of Benin as lecturer one with complimentary appointment as honorary consultant in 1997. He thereafter rose through the ranks to the position of professor in October 2010. His area of focus is maternal-fetal medicine and reproductive health. At the University of Benin and University of Benin Teaching Hospital, Professor Ande has served in the following capacities. Chief Resident Doctor, Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology, UBTH, 1996 to 1997. Coordinator, Continuing Medical Education for Maternal Healthcare Providers, Monthly Training Program for Private Medical Practitioners Involved in Paternal Healthcare. Coordinator, Prenatal and Early Neonatal Diagnosis Program, UBTH, 1998 to date. Course Advisor, School of Medicine, University of Benin, 2001 to date. Coordinator, Undergraduate Training, Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology, University of Benin, 1998 to 2003. Coordinator, Postgraduate Training, Department of Obs and Gyne, University of Benin, 2000 to 2002. Coordinator, Emergency Clinical Services and Special Duties, UBTH, 2010 to 2002 and 2002 to 2014. Head Department of ONG, 1998 to 2000 and 2010 to 2013. Professor Ande have also held the following administrative positions. Team Leader, Prevention of Maternal Mortality Project Benin, funded by Carnegie Corp, USA, 1995 to 2007. Vice President, Association of Resident Doctors, Department of Obs and Gynae, UBTH, 1996 to 1997. Associate Coordinator, Family Planning Service Delivery, Research and Training Project, UBTH, co-founded by Pathfinder International Boston, USA, 1996 to 2004. Vice Chairman, Theater Users Committee, UBTH 2004 to 2005. Secretary, Medical and Dental Consultant Association of Nigeria, UBTH Branch, 2004 to 2006. Vice Chairman, Maternal and Child Health Motivators Course, UBTH 2004 to 2007. Chairman, Medical and Dental Consultants Association of Nigeria, UBTH Branch, 2006 to 2009. Deputy Coordinator, Prevention of Maternal to Child Transmission of HIV/AIDS Program, UBTH 2006 to date. Member, Research and Ethics Committee, College of Medical Sciences, University of Benin, 2004 to date. In addition to undergraduate training and supervision, Professor Ande has been an external examiner, resource person, and external assessor at MA, MPH, and PhD levels in many universities within and outside Nigeria. It is noteworthy to say that he has served as external assessor for associates for A and P boards of several universities, as well as coordinating the MDCN assessment of foreign trained medical and dental doctors at UBTH 2005, 2008, 2011, and 2014. He has supervised more than 25 dissertations for professional fellowships in fields such as obstetrics and gynecology, hematology, ophthalmology, and Chemical Pathology. Professor Nde. Has attended several local, national, and international conferences, seminars, and workshops to present papers, review journals, or attend training programs. He has contributed to the advancement of knowledge with over 60 publications as chapters in books and peer review articles in both local and international journals. Osande is a member of the following learning societies: member, Nigerian Medical Association; member, Medical and Dental Consultant Association of Nigeria; member, Society of Gynecology and Obstetrics of Nigeria; fellow, International College of Surgeons, Nigerian chapter. Osande got married to Mrs. Oluyinka Oladoyin Andi Ni Adekola, and they are blessed with two lovely children. He is a Christian, and his hobbies include reading, listening to music, traveling, cycling, and long distance traveling. Ladies and gentlemen, before I introduce the inaugural lecturer for today, please permit me to, in view of what happened recently, a few days ago, of the demise of our professor, Professor J.U. Onakewo, shall we rise and give a minute silence in honor of the great academician. His gentle soul rest in perfect peace. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in inviting Professor Adedako Babatunde Ande, a professor of obstetrics and gynecology, to deliver this inaugural lecture.
Thank you, the Vice Chancellor, ably represented by the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Professor Paladin. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, I want to start on the existing protocol. The Vice Chancellor has told us of the tragedy that has happened in my department, the death of someone very close, particularly to me and everybody in the department of O&G. Because we know how we operate in the department, we are brothers. Joe Onokewo happened to be very close to me because we are in the same unit with Professor Okwere, and we tended to work together. Our professorships were announced in sequence, I before him though, but we are always together. And like Azike will say, we've adopted Onokewo to be part of our set. It's not an asset, but because he came without brothers to the residency program, he became an asset. I, in particular, had worked with Onokewo in the area of HIV/AIDS in pregnancy and out of pregnancy. I heard of the news of his passing on 2 a.m. two days or so. I was working on my stand, and I was so up to now, I can't believe that I would talk of Onokewo in the past. In view of this, I pray for God to grant me the grace to do what you expect me to do, to deliver the lecture as an obstetrician gynecology, storming through the storms and also through the calm. I had to delete some of the works we did together as relates to HIV/AIDS. I pray one day, maybe one of his children will talk on the work we did together. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go to what we should do today. Thank God the BBC has given us 1 minute silence. We will remember Onokewo for good. He was a nice guy. This inaugural lecture is dedicated to Oluyinka Oladoyin Ade Ni Adekola, my friend, lover, wife, companion, confidant. It is also dedicated to God Almighty for making everything possible. I thank the Vice Chancellor, Professor Olumase, for giving me the opportunity to deliver the 176th inaugural lecture of our great university. While appreciating the opportunity, my family, friends, and I continue to wish you and your esteemed management team Godspeed, piloting the affairs of our great institution to higher pedestals. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, ladies and gentlemen, today, to the glory of God, I'm here delivering the 176th inaugural lecture of our great university, which happens to be the seventh from the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology. To the glory of God, this is the 25th year of my commencing the residency training, specialist training in obstetrics and gynecology. It is also the 20th year of becoming a fellow of the West African College of Surgeons. And it is within 5 years of the announcement of our appointment as a professor of obstetrics and gynecology. Getting to this stage in my life is the Lord's doing. God and all individuals used by him are always remembered with great fondness and appreciation. Onokewo should not have left now. The Odyssey is a major ancient Greek epic poem attributed to Homer. The Odyssey focuses mainly on the Greek hero Odysseus. The Odyssey focuses mainly on Odysseus, who went through a journey of 10 years. And in the course of this journey, he passed through a lot of things. This was after the war of Trojan, which also took 10 years. You can imagine what that means and the experiences he must have. It is believed that the original poem was composed in an oral tradition by an epic poet or a singer, maybe a professional performer, are more likely intended to be heard than read. In the English language, the word Odyssey has come to refer to an epic voyage. An inaugural lecture celebrates appointment as an academic professor, stating one's contribution to the discipline as a public lecturer to a wider audience from the university and beyond. In the process, one is allowed to exaggerate a little, but truthfully, the importance of the discipline and one's place in it. I am an obstetrician gynecologist with special interest in maternal-fetal medicine and reproductive health. Simply stated, I am a doctor of women, and women are my constituency. Today's inaugural lecture is meant to be my duty as an obstetrician gynecologist, attempting to detail some of my experiences in the course of taking care of events and situations in women in an understandable manner to a mixed audience. How has these endeavors affected me and the women? Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, ladies and gentlemen, this is the focus of my epic voyage, my inaugural lecture. For the next couple of minutes, I plead your indulgence to hear my Odyssey as an obstetrician gynecologist. Mother who should be a teen of joy, which is a positive experience. But for many women across the world, including their families, pregnancy and childbirth are dangerous and frightening times in their life. It is unfortunate that many women still die in pregnancy at and within 6 weeks of childbirth. Maternal mortality is the most challenging health issue facing the health sector worldwide, especially when one considers the fact that it is not possible to eradicate it. I used to joke with my students that I will get a project that will be on eradicating maternal mortality, TMD and Professor Quere. You know that project will never end, so at least I will have a good car to be using. Okay, while majority of pregnancies end up in no life-threatening conditions, a proportion of them may result in near misses or mortality. Maternal near misses are more common than maternal mortalities. God is good. For every woman who dies, many more, 20 to 30 of them, will survive but often suffer from lifelong disabilities. These are what we call morbidities. The subject matter of maternal mortality and morbidity is of prime concern to any obstetrician and gynecologist practicing in a developing country. Little wonder that 3 of the 6 inaugural lectures delivered in the Department of O&D, that's 50%, dwelt so much on the issue of maternal mortality and morbidity. And if we look back, we remember that of Professor Rosain, that of Professor Konofa, and that of my able unit head, Professor Perret. Considering the deserved emphasis placed on the topic, it is inevitable that my odyssey will contain some of my experiences in the field of maternal morbidity and mortality. We shall look at some of the concepts for us to be able to understand what we are talking. A look in the World Health Organization's International Classification of Diseases provides series of lenses for defining maternal mortality and morbidity. Looking there, we see what a maternal mortality or death is. Simply means the death of a woman while pregnant or within 42 days of termination of pregnancy. It doesn't matter what the outcome of the pregnancy was. It doesn't matter at what gestational age. It doesn't matter all those other things. The fact is that the woman was pregnant and she died while pregnant or within 6 weeks of termination of pregnancy. There are some other qualifiers, but for this audience, we hold on to it. Another one we want to look at is a direct obstetric death. What is a direct obstetric death? Results from obstetric complications of pregnancy, such as things that happen in pregnancy, labor, and the puerperium. Puerperium simply means after the delivery. Most of the time, we use 6 weeks. So, an intervention or even omission, incorrect treatment, or from a chain of events resulting from any of these. Okay, those are what we call direct causes. Then the indirect ones are those from existing diseases or diseases that develop during pregnancy, which are not due to the direct obstetric causes, but are aggravated by physiological effects of pregnancy. I'm a Yoruba man, and we know that the pregnancy time and delivery is the riskiest of the period for a woman. And those who believe in powers that but not up to God, that's the time that they say they can attack. God will protect our women. Maternal morbidities are any health condition attributed to and or aggravated by pregnancy or childbirth that has a negative impact on a woman's well-being. These are illnesses associated with pregnancy that makes her not good. Pregnancy is a physiological state. Without women, there will be no human being. So, and God has so done it that they should carry on the pregnancy normally. But when they have this issue, it's a challenge to all of us. Then what is a maternal near miss or severe acute maternal morbidity? This is a new concept or a concept that we have to look into. We say several women don't die. They live. They must have gone through a tunnel, which others went through, but they didn't survive. We have information to get from such women. They are the ones that will tell us exactly what they saw, and if it was their mothers that sent them back from where they were knocking up. These are events in which a pregnant woman comes close to maternal death. But thank God she didn't die, so we pray that we see more of this. And it also tells us of the care we give at the different hospitals. Because when you consider dwelling more on mortalities, it depresses the system. This one died, that one died. Are there no women that come and survive? They help us to encourage us. They help us to show that the system is good. Nigeria is not that bad. We are not doing bad. CMD, I tell you this. Let us know. The indicators of maternal mortality, we try to measure how we're doing. One of them is the maternal mortality ratio. It's just a statistical way of assessing. It talks of deaths during a given time period by 100,000 live births during the same period. simply just take them. There are controversies about this definition. What of if those women that have dead babies delivered? Is it not to be considered as a denominator? So there are issues, but we are not into talking too much grammar today. Let's just take the fact and think the pieces. Maternal mortality rate is the number of maternal deaths in a population divided by the number of women of reproductive age expressed by 1,000 women. Okay. Well, we want to look at the causes. I won't belabor you too much on this. We know that things that happen that kill women in Nigeria are also the things that kill women in Europe and America. But the difference is that we tend to have more of those events that could have been managed better, either due to ignorance on the part of the woman or other things. So you talk of things like hemorrhage, bleeding, simply sepsis, which means infection, eclampsia, that's high blood pressure with convulsion. You talk of obstructed labor and abortion. So when we are looking at this, we look at medical causes. So these are direct causes and contributes about 80%. Then you have indirect causes about 20%. The major ones are hemorrhage, that's bleeding, and it's mainly after delivery. The good thing is when a woman is pregnant, all attention is on her. But as soon as she delivers, my experience even in labor work, is that what the man looks for is that baby, not the woman. So even the tendency of the healthcare giver is to leave once the pregnancy has been. Yeah? Just expect the baby comes out, every attention goes on to the mother. So it tends to be more in the postpartum period. That's why you see obituaries died after childbirth. Why did she die? Why she was pregnant? Everybody takes care of them then. Infection, usually postpartum too, after delivery. Preeclampsia and eclampsia, these are conditions in which a woman has high blood pressure. And when she now feeds, that's what we call eclampsia. Unsafe abortion, very common, obstructed labor. Okay? Non-medical causes which include socioeconomic factors, cultural, religious beings, and things that push down a woman as a human being. And women themselves, I have a theory that a woman puts herself at number 5. You can see me for that at the cost after the lecture. And even the men, the husband puts the woman as number 5. That's not the issue for discussion today. But these are issues relating to gender inequality, poor girl education. And these are very important to us. So let's now start talking of what my experiences are as relates to this maternal mortality and morbidity. Well, I was fortunate to have joined the residency in O&G at the time that, well, in Nigeria there was objectivity. You saw my biography, you had the BC ticket. I'm a stranger in a